Morning, Deuce. How's it going?
Hey, little barn kitties.
Meow.
Yeah.
Good morning, chickens. Morning, Lucky. Vivian, get back in the coop. Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna have fun today. Let's get going. How's it going, guys? Yeah, pretty good. Getting all this fence taken down. Cool. Alright. This is the one here that when I pulled it out this morning, it snapped in half and Van watched me fall on my butt. So that was fun. It wasn't funny. Stop laughing. It's funny how you can own things but not know exactly how things work. I think I had the tractor for 4 years before I realized it had parking brakes. Easy. I don't know if we need all this weight on here, but I think we're gonna leave it just because I'm feeling lazy. Yeah, they just weighed it down so that it kind of goes into the ground a little bit deeper. But we're gonna keep the back carriage hooked up, but we're not really gonna be using it. So I'm not gonna put any pitch on it. It's just gonna kind of cruise with. We don't really need to do much here, so. All right? Yep. So basically, this is where we grew all of our corn this year. Worked out fantastic. And now it's kind of time to get it prepped for winter and start working on next year's compost for the planter boxes. So hopefully next year we're going to have a lot more room out here. Some of this cleanup here, but right now I'm waiting on Sarah. She ran to the store and I want to see if she wants to get rid of her zucchini plants back here, or if we're going to leave them. So basically all I'm trying to do here is just knock down these mounds that I made earlier in the year when I was running the hilling machine, just to make it a little bit easier to get out here. And then move little doggies. Ultimately, this is what I want to see out here is all these birds out here picking through everything. I added a little bit of feed out here to kind of encourage them to hang out for a little bit. And they'll start finding all kinds of other stuff, and then they'll be putting down their own fertilizer as well, starting to get this ground nice and fertile. It's nice to see the chickens out.
Yeah.
Wish those ones over there would figure out that they can get out of there.
We're in the planter box garden today, probably doing one of our last harvests before frost sets in. So I'm picking carrots because they're finally ready, and I'm going to make a stew tonight. It's a good one. Another good sized one. A little teeny but long. Size one. Nice white one. And then the kids will probably just eat them. Otherwise, I'm going to pick tomatoes too, because as soon as frost comes and you can't do much with them. So we'll go through and pick any. Even if they're green, they can ripen off the vine, or we can make fried green tomatoes. But I think this week, unless the weather's changed, it's supposed to probably frost out. So tomatoes are still doing good. The only downside is as soon as frost comes, then they get ruined. So that's always a bummer. But we still have some sizable ones. And I like fried green tomatoes. And they'll ripen off the vine if you put them in the sun. They're not quite as tasty when they're off the vine to ripen, but they're still good. Still better than store-bought. So as far as the planter box garden, this will probably be the last harvest for it. And then we'll work on takedown and prepping the soil for next year. Which you can see Shane has already started by looking behind me. And also the chickens are free ranging again, as you can hear. Some nice sized ones again. Little reddening one. Not the prettiest, but still tasty. Some little cherry ones. Those always do really well. They're pretty easy to grow. They kind of overtake the garden. So Shane went through the fenced-in garden, which is obviously not the fenced-in garden anymore. And I asked him to leave my zucchini because zucchini will still produce. The cucumbers, unfortunately, had died out. So we went through and did a final pick through yesterday, me and the kids did. But the zucchini will still probably produce for a couple more weeks. So we'll just leave them and see how they do. So I'm just kind of going through it to see what we have on them. I see a few little ones. Squash are a little hardier. If it doesn't stay cold, if it frosts and then warms up, they'll probably be okay. However, if frost hits and stays cold, then it is what it is. But there are quite a few little ones growing, which is why I didn't want to quite say goodbye, because they are still producing, and these ones should be ready to pick probably before the first frost. They'll probably be ready in a day or two, maybe three tops, the way zucchini grow. They kind of grow overnight, and then they get too big. So, like I said, I'll just have to keep an eye on these for the next couple of days, and I think they'll be ready to pick. We'll just kind of wander down here. So there's a couple growing right here. This one I'll probably pick in a day or two also. It's a pretty good size, but it'll probably grow an inch or two, which then it'll be perfect. So I am glad we decided to leave these ones. And again, over here we have a couple little ones that are still producing, and some on this one are still doing pretty good also. So again, a couple of days we'll pick through these and we'll see how the frost goes. Maybe we can get 2-3 weeks out of them if we're lucky, which would be nice. Soil's looking good though. We are back in the planter box garden. Today I'm tearing everything down because the season's pretty much over. Unfortunately, it's that sad time of year where you gotta rip everything up and prep for the next year. So here we go. I'm putting it all in our compost to be used for mulch. One of the smarter things we did with this garden back here, which I'm pretty pleased with, is we built our own compost right over there. So it makes end of the year cleanup a lot nicer. It'll also make next year, after we rake through this and we put some of that compost on top, a lot easier, so you're not running all over the place. So that was a well thought out plan. Should have brought my loppers back here. So there are still a few tomatoes on here, but unfortunately they were eaten by worms. So that's why I'm not picking them. And that chicken over there is just sitting here waiting her turn to jump in here and eat it all. We always reuse these, so I try not to destroy them too much. Otherwise it just makes more work for Shane to have to weld together. But with this particular one, you can see the damage those worms do. Really unfortunate. But as you can see, because of the straw, we really didn't get any weeds in between here, which is nice. And you can tell how healthy the soil is, because you still got these nice guys crawling all over. But I mean, really, no weeds. These are so intertwined, I don't even know how to get them out. So now we're weeding the other tomato, or pulling up the other tomato patch, which the soil's looking really healthy over here too. And the straw again worked amazingly. I really didn't weed out in this area, so I think we'll use more straw next year if we have it. If Shane goes back through the back field again, then we don't have to buy it. Otherwise, grass clippings also work really well if you start saving them soon enough so you have a ton of them, which now that we know how well that worked, next year I think we'll be saving more grass clippings to make that a cheaper mulch. I have a love hate with this time of year because all your hard work of summer is just gone, but it's exciting to learn from what you did that season for the next season to make it easier and less work. And every year you build on what you learned from the year before and it makes it just that much easier. So it's kind of a bittersweet time of year. I think I might have to go get a loppers. This is ridiculous. Nice roots though. Those are long and really grew in there nicely. Look at all them worms. They're just everywhere. Beautiful. I do love how amazing tomato plants smell. We'll have to let the chickens get in here and eat up all the bad worms, so we don't have a problem next year. They're good pest control. If we didn't have such a worm problem, I'd let them go longer, but it's kind of pointless when, you know, there's not enough of a harvest to make it worth the battle. Well, I'd like to tear all this up and put garlic and onions in the Planaroxes for next year, but. Oh, just when I thought it was undamaged. Oh, that one's good. Keep that one. That one's good too. So what happens to tomatoes when you leave them after frost is they get mushy. So they're, I mean, you could eat them, but they're like super disgusting. But they literally just get, like the inside is mushy. You cut into them and it's just all mush. Feeds the earth for next season. That one's eaten away too. These tomato cages we've had for like 5 years, so they're worth the investment when you buy really good ones and you have a place to store them outside of weather. We store ours in our greenhouse in the winter, which is nice. If only growing things was as easy as tearing them down. Hey, Deuce. You come to help now that all the work's done? That's about right. So since we're tearing everything down, I'm gonna finish with carrots here and just pull up what we have left, rake it out. And you're gonna help Deuce? The little ones I'll probably just feed to the chickens. Ducks don't like them. These planter box gardens work really well because they're minimal weeding and can get a lot longer. We've done hilling in the past with them out where the back garden used to be, or the green garden that was fenced in. And they didn't do quite as well there because the soil wasn't easy to grow down in for whatever reason. So as you can see, some of these are in the ground without a stem. I suspect that's from my children trying to pull them out. And we have soil, or worms everywhere. Go ahead and edit me fighting this out, that'd be great. This is just embarrassing at this point.
Sit, Sadie, sit. Good dog.